Now we have to see from shloka number 15. Sarvari sarva jiva raksha naika shaline namah shivaya parvati priyaya bhakta paline namah shivaya durvidagdha daitya sainya dharine namah shivaya sarvarisha dharine kapaline namah shivaya. The first line is sarva jiva raksha naika shaline. सर्व जीवः रक्षः, रक्ष टू प्रोटेक्ट, ही इज प्रोटेक्टिंग ऑल द जीवः. सो भगवान डजंट डिस्क्रिमिनेट बिटवीन यू नो फ्रेंड्स एंड फोर्स. इफ समबडी डज समथिंग रॉन्ग ही विल पनिश. दिस इज लाइक मदर पनिशिंग हर ओन चाइल्ड. यू नो मदर शी विल पनिश हर ओन चाइल्ड बट शी विल नेवर हेट हर चाइल्ड, राइट. द सेम वे even you know all those devils, all those daityas, all those asuras, Bhagavan punishes them, Parameshwara punishes them, but he never hates them. He punishes them in order to teach them a lesson. Sarva jiva rakshanaika shaline namah shivaya. You know, there exists a story. Apparently in very very old days in Tamil Nadu, there existed a uttama atma. You know, he is a very rich man. What he does is that he feeds all the people. In olden days, even now, there are still people who are hungry, who don't have access to food that we have. And in olden days, you know, people like them, people, you know, all the rich people, in the afternoon, they feed the poor for free. Without getting any money, they will feed the poor. They did that as a service to the humanity. What this person particularly did was, he will be standing in front of that room where he is, you know, going to serve, and every person has to chant Shiva Shiva before he enters into the Bhojanashala is the dining room. When the person says Shiva Shiva, he will say Alodha. If somebody does not say Shiva Shiva, he will not allow them inside the room. So normally, you know what people do? All the poor people, because they want food, because they are so hungry, they will say Shiva Shiva and he will allow them inside the house and they will be properly fed and taken care of. There came, you know, one day, a person who is a complete atheist. He will not even say Shiva Shiva or any other God's name even in his dreams. So that person, he came to that Bhojanashala. He wanted to enter into the Bhojanashala. And this rich person asked him to say Shiva Shiva. That person will not say. He will say that, okay, Shiva has never given me any food or any money. Why should I say Shiva's name? This rich person got so angry. He said, okay, if you are not going to say Shiva's name, you are not going to get food here. The other person, he was so staunch in his belief. He did not have his next meal. That is okay. He was so staunch in his belief that he said, okay, let it be. If only by uttering Shiva's name I am going to get food, let me not get food today. Let me starve today. Saying this, he went home. You know, he went to other place in search of food. And this rich man, you know, he offered the food for everyone. The same night he came, he slept. But he was still angry with that person. How can a person not say Shiva's name? I am offering him food. He is not even saying Shiva's name. How can that be? He slept off. And Lord Parameshwara came in that person's dream. Came in the rich person's dream. Even in the dream, he is arguing with Shiva. He says to Shiva, hey Shiva, see, look at him. He is not even telling your name. So I taught him a lesson. I punished him by not giving food today. You know what Shiva said? Hey Muda, he is referring to the rich person as Muda. Muda means an idiot. Hey idiot, that person's age is around 50. For 50 years, I have been giving him food even if he doesn't say my name. For 50 years, I have been providing him with food. He is living because I give him food. He is not telling my name. Yes, I know. He is not worshipping me. Yes, I know. He doesn't even believe me that I exist. Or he always calls me, or he, you know, Dushana. He makes Dushana of me. But even then, I give him food because he is my child. I am not coming here in your dream in order to praise you for what you have done. I am coming in your dream in order to, you know, punish you, in order to shout at you for not giving food to that person. That is the Karuna of Parameshwara. He never ever, you know, discriminates between his devotees. He is Sarva Jana Rakshaka. That's what this name says. Sarva Jiva Rakshanaika Shaline Namashivaya. Because he is the father. Vagartha Viva Sampritto Vagartha Pradipataye Jagata Pitaro Vande Parvati Parameshwaro. He is the Pita. Parvati is the Mata. He is the Pita for everybody in this universe. So, he is Sarva Jiva Rakshaka. Next line. Parvati Priyaya Bhakta Paline Namashivaya. Bhakta Paline, Bhakta devotees. Paline, Pa, to protect. He protects all the devotees. What to say of devotees? You know, he protects even his worst enemies. So what to say of his devotees? He is Bhakta Paline. He is also Parvati Priya. He is very, very dear to Parvati. How do we know he is very, very dear to Parvati? We give everything for our friends, right? If some person is very dear to us, we give him everything. What we won't give him is our body itself. But look at Parameshwara. Parameshwara has given half of his body to Parvati. Sardhanarishwara, he only has half of his own body. And the rest of the half, you know, the remaining half belongs to Parvati. He is so dear of Parvati that he even gave half of his body to Parvati. That's why it's called as Parvati Priya. Next line. Durvidhatta Daitya Sainya Dharine Namashivaya. So here comes the punishing aspect of Parameshwara. He punishes, he teaches a lesson to all the Daityas. Daityas or Asuras. I have previously told why Daitya has got their name. Because they are born out of Diti. Kashyapa as a Maharishi. Kashyapa Maharishi has got two wives. One wife is called Diti and another wife is called as Aditi. Those who are born of Diti are called as Daityas. Those who are born of Aditis are called as Adityas. Daityas are normally Asuras and Adityas are Devas. So Devas and Asuras, they are not two different races as people refer to them now. They are own brothers, but because of their habits, you know, Ditis, they have Rajoguna and Tamoguna, and Adityas, the Devas, they have Sattogunas. So that's why these people are Devas and those people are Asuras. And Parameshwara, he teaches all the Daityas a lesson. He wants them to repent for their wrongdoing. So, he is Durvidatta Daitya Sainya Dharine Namashivaya. Next, last name in this shloka, Sharvarisha Dharine Kapaline Namashivaya. Kapaline. He is called as Kapali. Why is he called as Kapali? Because he has got a Kapala in his hand. You know whose Kapala that is? That is Brahmaji's Kapala. Brahma, the husband of Saraswati, previously has got five heads. Now if you see Brahma's photo, he only has got four heads, right? Previously Brahmaji used to have five heads. And he was so filled with ego that he did something very, very wrong. And Parameshwara, in order to teach him a lesson, he basically, pulled Brahmaji's head. And Brahmaji's head got stuck to Parameshwara's hand. And head is called as Kapala in Sanskritam. That's why Parameshwara is called as Kapali. Sarvarisha Dharine. He not only has got Kapala in his hand, but he also has got nice crescent moon in his head, right? Sarvarisha dharine kapaline namashivaya. Shloka number 16. Pahimam umaman pahimam umamanogya dehate namashivaya. Dehime varam sita drigehate namashivaya. Mohitarshikamini samuhate namashivaya. Vehita prasanna kama dohate namashivaya. The 16th shloka, the first two lines is where Acharya is making a prayer. In all the 27 shlokas, Acharya doesn't ask for anything back. He says, praises to you, Parameshwara, praises to you, Parameshwara. Namashivaya, namaha, namaha, namaha. In 16th shloka, first two lines, Acharya is actually praying for something. What is he praying for? Pahimam Uma Manognya Dehate. Uma Manognya Dehate. Deha body. The one whose body, in whose body Uma is present. Uma Manognya Deha. Pahimam. Pa to protect. Pahimam. Hey Parameshwara, please protect me. Says Acharya. Next, Dehi me varam. Pitadri gehate namashivaya. Sita adri geha. Adri means mountain. Sitadri is Himalayan mountain because it is very, very cold. Sitadri geha, the one whose house is Himachala. Parameshwara is present in Kailasa. Parameshwara's abode is Kailasa. It is present in Himachala. That's why he is called as Sitadri geha. And he Sitadri geha, dehi me varam. Dehi, please give me, unto me, varam. Please give whatever I want. Hey Parameshwara, hey Sitadri Deha, hey Sitadri Geha, dehi me varam. Thirdly, Mohitarshi Kamini Samuhate Namashivaya. So this is a leela of Parameshwara, which happened in Darukavana. In Darukavana, there existed Maharishis. No, Maharishis are saints. Normally when we say Maharishi, you know, they are all, you know, holy people. They do lot of yajnas, they do lot of pujas, they do lot of tapas and lot. That's what we think, right? In olden days, there existed a philosophy. It is called as Karma Mimamsa. According to that philosophy, I do a work, I reap the benefits. I do a karma and I reap its benefits. There is no need for Bhagavan to give me benefits. That was their philosophy in old days. Those people are called as Mimamsakas. And, you know, just like Vedanta or Bhakti school, Mimamsaka was once a very, very famous school. And Parameshwara wanted them to teach a lesson because they were all doing very, very big yajnas, but without any bhakti in their mind. So Parameshwara, in order to teach them a lesson, in order to teach about bhakti, came to all the rishis' house as a beautiful young man. And he was so beautiful that all the rishi patris, all the rishi putras, even all the cows in the rishis' houses started following Parameshwara. Parameshwara came as a beggar. He was going to each and every house in order to beg. But he was so beautiful that all the rishi patnis and putras and even the animals, they started following Parameshwara. And rishis, they got so angry. This was happening in a place called as Tarukavana. So the Tarukavana rishis, the rishis present in the Tarukavana, they were so angry. They started doing a very big yajna. And from that yajna, many, many different kinds of demons came in order to destroy Parameshwara because they did not know that the beggar was Parameshwara. So they were doing yajna just like, you know, in movies, all the demons started coming out from yajna and Parameshwara, just by smiling, he started destroying them. And after some time, one big asura called as Muyalaka came. And Parameshwara, he actually stepped over Muyalaka. And that is the Asura we can still see under Nataraja. You know, Nataraja's feet, when you observe closely, actually there is a person under the feet of Nataraja. And that he was a demon. And that demon is called as Muyalaka. And Muyalaka was, you know, created by the Dharukavana Rishi in order to destroy the beggar who deluded, you know, who attracted all the Dharukavana Rishi's properties. And that's what here it is said as Mohita Rishi Kamini Samuhati Namashivaya, the one who attracted Rishi Kamini, the one who attracted all the wives of all the Rishis in the Dharukavana. Unto him I offer my Namaskara. The fourth line is Svehita Prasanna Kama Dohate Nam Shivaya. The one who is always smiling, who is ever calm. Parameshwara is ever, ever calm. When he gets angry, there came the big Uritti. That's what in Tamil we call. Uritti is the end of all the time. You know, when time ended, everything gets absorbed onto Parameshwara. And when the time comes, he started creating. And in between, he is ever calm. Vehita prasanna kama dohate. If you see Dakshinamurti, he is ever calm, ever pleasant, ever peaceful. To him, I offer my namaskarat. Sloka number 17. Mangala pradaya go turangate namashivaya. Gangaya tarangi tota mangate namashivaya. Sankara pravritti vairi bhangate namashivaya. Angajaraye kare kurangate namashivaya. First line is Mangala pradaya go turangate namashivaya. Go turanga. The one whose ride is a go. Go means here it's ox. The one whose vahana is ox, to him I offer my namaskara. You know what is the ox? What is the vahana? What does that ox represent? The ox represents dharma and Vedas. In Tamil, the Nandi Bhagavan is called as Vidai. He is not a normal Vidai. He is dharma Vidai. So Nandi is an embodiment of dharma. So whenever during Pradosha time, people say, oh, you have to see Lord Shiva within the two horns of Parameshwara. And people take it so literally, they go and stand behind the Nandi. They try to see the Moolavar Lingam between the two horns. You should not take it literally. What that means is there, the Nandi represents Vedas. You have to worship Parameshwara through Vedas. You have to see Parameshwara through the Vedas during Pradosha time. That is what it represents. Because Parameshwara, after some time, there existed, you know, lot of mathas, lot of religion, where all the avaidika practices came into existence. You know, whatever things that are not told in Vedas, people started practicing. People say, no, 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 this is going to satisfy Parameshwara. So what Shastra says is, you should not do that. During Pradosha time, you have to worship Parameshwara through Vedas. Vedas are Dharma. Dharma is the Vidai. Dharma is the Nandi. That is why he is called as Goturangate Namashivaya. And Mangala Pradaya Shivam. The literal meaning of the word Shivam itself means Mangalam. So he provides all the Mangalam to all the human beings. He is the embodiment of auspiciousness. That's why he is called as Mangala Pradaya. Gangaya Tarangi Tota Mangate Namashivaya. The one whose head, from whose head Ganges flow, to him I offer my namaskara. Because Ganges was so needed in the earth for so many reasons, because Ganges purifies wherever it goes. Wherever she goes, Ganga purifies. That's why Adi Shankara says in Bhajagovindam, Bhagavad Gita Kinchita Dita, Ganga Jala Lava Ganika Pita. You should always chant Bhagavad Gita. You should always drink Ganga water, says Adi Shankara in his Bhajagovindam, because Ganga purifies everything. And when Ganga was needed so badly in the earth, Ganga was so afraid that, you know, if she is flowing in the earth with her full force, the earth itself will become destroyed. So they all the devas prayed to Parameshwara. Parameshwara accepted Ganga in his head so that his Jatamuti can slow down the force of Ganga and does not do any harm to the earth. That's why he's called as Gangaya Tarangitota Mangate Namashivaya. Third line. Sangara Pravritti Vairi Bhangate Namashivaya. Vairi means enemies. Bhanga means to destroy. The one who destroys all the enemies. So these are not the enemies that are present outside. These are the enemies that are present in our own hearts. You know, Shastras talk about Shat Ripus. Ripus means enemies. Shat is six. There are six enemies that are being talked about in Shastra. They are Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Mada and Matsarya. And Parameshwara destroys all the enemies. That's why he is called as Sankara Pravritta Vairi Bhangate Namashivaya. And the last line is Angajaraye Kare Kurangate Namashivaya. Ari is the enemy. Angaja Ari. The one who is the enemy of Angaja. So now we need to know who is Angaja. Angaja is a technical name for Kamadeva. Because Kamadeva was born out of Mahavishnu's body, Mahavishnu's Angam, he is called as Angaja. Angajaraye, the one who destroyed Kamadeva. He is Angajaraye. We all know the story. Parameshwara, it's his third eye. The third eye represents Jnanam. In Tamil, it is called as Jnanakan, Jnana Chakshuhu. When Parameshwara opened his third eye, and Parameshwara opened his Jnana Kan, Kama got destroyed. What does that signify? Whenever we get Jnanam, whenever we get knowledge, all the Kamas, all the desire get destroyed. Jnana Agni Datta Sarva Karmana. Bhagavan Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. Jnana Agni, the fire of knowledge, will destroy all the papas, and Parameshwara has shown us that by opening his third eye, he destroyed Kamadeva. On to him, I offer my namaskara. Kare kurangate namashivaya. If you observe very closely, Parameshwara has got four hands, right? In one of the hand, he has got Shula, Trishula. In the other hand, you can actually see a deer. D-E-E-R, deer, maan. Maana kailo chindrupar Parameshwara. The deer represents our mind. You know, deer runs so fast. Our mind also runs so fast. What is meaning by running is imagining. We will be in the US, but we can imagine what's happening in India. We are now at 2020. Our mind will start imagining about what is going to happen at 2060. No, when my son is born, when he is getting married, when he is getting a child, I am saving all the money for him. We imagine everything. That's why manas is often referred to as horse, because it runs so fast. And Parameshwara is having that horse in his hand. Even that horse which runs so fast stays still in Parameshwara's hand. It means he has mastered his mind. What he is signifying, that we also should master our own mind. And that's what is the significance. We have to master our own mind. We should not let mind, you know, take its own decision. And that's why he is called as Kare Kurangate Namashivaya. The one who has got deer in his hand. To him, I offer my namaskara. So with this shloka number 17, we will end here. We will see shloka number 18 on.